All right.
Hey, we're back.
Yeah. I got my armor on. We just did a shrine, for the record. It really doesn't seem to affect movement.
Well,
I think I said that in the last
I'm sure they know that, Biff. I'm sure they're so eager to watch this that they're watching it all in one sitting.
They must be. I mean, I probably said it last time, but it doesn't appear to affect your movement at all. Everything else appears to be fine. I can still jump like a quick guy.
I'm a little worried about the frame rate, because I heard it's laggy on the Nintendo Switch, and we're on the Wii U, and it like this town, you can see the frame rate drop.
I mean, it does a little bit when there's a ton of stuff happening, but it's not too bad. I mean, it's a little bad when there's like a ton of stuff happening in the background. But
this is just a village. Imagine if we were into a town.
There's not going to be one. This is a post-apocalypse. This is probably as village as, or as town as we get.
Alright, well, that looks like the mayor's
tinkerer
or something. Yeah, there was supposed to be a tinkerer in this village, but
I couldn't hear anything over the radar telling me there was a shrine up there I had to go do.
Also,
that is a windy fire.
Also, Billy Bob or Pinhead Larry or whatever his name is was giving you your doubts because there's some hick at the village.
Oh, yeah, the guy entrance. With the pitchfork at the entrance to the village that was like,
"Hey, what you doing?
Get from my lawn, you damn kids.
You better get out here. We're only friendly folk. Don't make me stab you because I'm a friendly folk."
We always say hello to everyone with the pitchfork in our hands, pointed at your face.
La la.
Standard tradition.
Come on in!
Oh god.
Or come on in!
Wasn't sure if that was guy or girl.
As long as it's not a toad.
Yep.
Nothing like a little bit of ear.
A pot lid.
A pot lid? Oh,
yeah, did you see it
over there? Yeah, it's probably
a
shield.
It's the shield that's one defense.
Oh, is it?
And it breaks easy?
Yeah, probably. That makes sense. It's a pot lid.
You're not gonna talk to her?
Talk to who? There's nobody in there.
Go in here. The door's not closing you. Look left.
She wasn't there a minute ago.
She was there the whole time. Good job.
I glanced quickly and didn't really read it. It kind of looked like her name said pizza.
No, it's Pizza Prima.
Hulu. Tanpu.
Welcome to the Tanpu Inn. A regular bed is 20 rupees. Or if you're looking for a relaxing and restroom mind-body experience, you can have one for an extra soft downy beds. For 40.
We're good.
One, you have the downs. We're not the downs. You're the downs. And two, I'll totally spend double for some happy time on your soft bed. That's totally what that meant.
Yeah.
If you want the special bedroom, it'll cost 40. Oh, look at these windmills. Ooh, there. Look at the smoke up there. Oh, you probably doesn't need that. Can your opponent hear us? Yep, your opponent's coming.
Just want to make sure, you know?
Yeah, get up on the hill. There. Opponent's like, fine, jeez.
I think it stops wherever you make the noise last, so I didn't want to try and run up on the hill. I didn't want you to get lost, horsey. Thanks. Unlike the other game, this game specifically told you, don't get too far from your horse or it's not going to appear. Twilight Princess was like, he whistled for your horse. Your horse mystically shows up literally out of nowhere. Like, you could be anywhere in the universe and just bust off one of these little things of horse grass, which you had to find, look like little horseshoes, and you made the whistly sound and your horse was just like, I got it.
How is this, I know this is the only village we run into, but how does this village fare against the standard village stereotype in the other games?
I think it's pretty similar.
Ancient Tech Lab. There we go.
Ancient Tech Lab. That's what we want.
Nice. No, yeah.
No soliciting.
He's an angry old guy.
Great.
No soliciting! Get you out of here! Darn kids!
Oh, oh, the god, there's more messages. Oh, jeez.
Gotta make Hyrule great again! With all these signs.
Mind the lanterns.
Mind the lanterns!
What am I minding them for? They're not in my way.
Don't take my apples!
Didn't say that. I'm taking them. Besides, I don't know.
I need to say it. It's my right to have my own apples.
Yay! He just comes to wherever I am standing. That's great.
Hey, right. No horses!
Let's go.
They poop everywhere.
Yep.
They eat my apples. Damn horses.
Whew. Enter at your own risk.
Oh, boy.
Oh, jeez. Stay here, opponent. It's dangerous.
At your own risk. Look at this nice little shack place. It doesn't look nice. Look at the frog statue on the top of the building. Look at that. It's like, yeah, it's quite the ribbit.
Oh. Ribbit, oh.
Well, it's a good thing you didn't sell all your gears and stuff. That was a good idea to keep them.
Yeah, I kind of figured they might be.
Because I'm sure he'll be like, I can make you something super awesome, but it'll be 500 gears, 3,000 screws, and one rare item that you can only get if you farm those robots.
If you somehow manage to kill one, you probably get something.
Wait, what's that sign say?
Oh yeah, we have read all the other ones.
If the flame is blue, the furnace is hot. Do not touch!
It's called a furnace. What would make me think that I could touch it with my hands?
I don't know. But he's got the eye thing on the door. Oh. Oh, hey, there's two people.
Is it a duo?
Whoa, it looks like this was formerly a shrine. Look here.
Mm-hmm.
Can you distill? No. You can't distill root.
He's taking it apart. Or it's not active yet.
Is that a little girl or is that a grandma?
It's a little old lady. It's a little old lady or some little fairy person of some kind. And think some bulky old guy. Hello.
Oh, I like her little bow goggles thing.
Pura.
Good evening. Wait, wrong character.
Good evening. This is the Hato Ancient Tech Lab. Do you have some business with the director? The director is in the back. Total 10 feet away from me, which is very far with my small feet. A terribly busy person, though, that one. Best to keep it brief. Not boxers.
Good evening. I imagine you've never seen so many books in one place. Pretty incredible, isn't it?
Hmm. What's a book? Just kidding.
Ah, I see. You are like the villagers.
Just
well, then we have no business. Carry on. We've gathered all of Hyrule's known literature on ancient civilizations here. Sorry,
civilizations.
Have had possibly too much sake. As for the actual number of books, well, let me just stare at your face. That'll make me remember. Is that thing on your waist? Is that a Sheikah? There's no mistaking it. That's a real Sheikah slate, isn't it?
That's what everyone keeps calling it.
Your warranty is still active? That is amazing. I've never actually seen one in person with its warranty still intact.
Well, I mean, if you polish it every couple days, it works great.
If you could just show me the runes on it, I'd be most appreciative and use them for my own vile means, me most appreciative. Stasis, magnesis, yes, yes. A remote bomb and cryonis? I'll call it cryonis for now. And what else? Let's see. That's it for runes besides the amiibo icon, but, strange. Doesn't seem like you have the basic runes. I don't understand why they're missing. There must be some reason.
Well, a dead ghost of the king gave it to me and told me my epic quest as the Knight of Princess Zelda was to stop that apocalypse Ganon. So...
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
You can use the Guidance Stone here to reboot those runes.
The one that's broke?
It's not broke.
Oh, I had to talk to you first.
Before you can do that, you'll need to talk to me first and get approval from Lady Impa. The one that you're supposed to go to for the main storyline.
Damn it. An old hag lives 4 miles away. Why do I need to go talk to her?
Because reasons.
Damn it. That's why it's not turned on. I gotta talk to Lady Impa. She did give me permission. I don't have permission. I can't do it.
You missed one apple.
Yeah, I don't want that one.
Wait, is that a cannon?
Yeah, it's probably a cannon, yeah.
It said it's a furnace.
Yeah. But that's a cannon.
No, it's a telescope. Look, you can...
Is it? Oh, God.
Get up there with your crazy ninja skills.
I don't think I can climb over that roof. No. Oh, yeah, okay.
There's a way.
Just derp through the roof. Don't mind me. Oh, there's a staircase.
That goes to a door that's walled off. Okay. Like the little umbrella. Really adds a nice finishing touch.
Where are you looking so intently? Can I use it?
Wait, use your usable. You don't need to use it. You have your Sheikah slate. Zoom in over there.
How do I zoom in?
I think it was R3.
Oh, that's not it.
R3? Click in with the right... Yeah. So let's see.
Where are you looking?
That's what it is on most modern games.
Huh.
It might not be rendering it, but that might be Ganon's castle, or castle over there,
right.
Ganon. Is there something in that chest right there?
I don't think so.
Storage box?
Not even a chest.
Nope.
Nope, it's just a step.
Might as well see what's at the top here, while the sun rises.
Alright,
And we glitch into the side.
Gonna glitch into the stairs here. What the hell's this?
It might make us go inside, so let's go up. Maybe not hug the wall, since we seem to merge with it. Whoa! It's one of the robots up here. It's legs.
There is a robot up there. Let me climb it. Nope, can't do that there.
I wonder what that says.
No. You can't read it. Well, don't speak Hyrulean.
Oh, is this...
You got a bunch of notes and stuff up here. This may be some sort of lab.
Wait, where's the ladder go? Or is that just that's just to get up. Wow, he's written so much on his equation that he had
to
go past
to write on
his
the ceiling.
That's a nice little detail.
Yeah.
Ooh, what's that?
What's this? I don't
know. Oh, it's like the tops of little robots or something.
The tops of something. Can I derp through the roof right here?
Whoa.
There's a guy.
Yeah, a little. Oh, look at you, Mr. Master Climber, full plate.
Oh, yes.
Holy crap. Praise. Examine.
Ha ha!
Yeah.
I knew it!
Yeah, you found me! Here's another seed. Now get the fuck out. Bye bye!
Bye bye!
Wow. That view.
That is a view.
Let's hope you don't fall.
Let's hope I remember to use my glider.
Yeah.
Let's jump. Jump. Ha!
Whee! Bye, Epona. Bye forever.
Oh my god, there's wind.
Boop. Alright, well, I guess we're gonna go to Impa.
Thank you for railroading the railroad to railroad town. Maximum railroad to the railroadiness.
That's fine, we got to go this way, and we got to see that robot, and you got to get your own horse.
And I got the shrine, so I can fast travel back.
And we got armor and stuff. We wouldn't have got armor and stuff if we went straight to her.
Right. Alright, now the real quick, we gotta get our bearings here, so hold on a minute there, horse.
What? What's going on?
Find out where the hell we're supposed to go.
Oh, just take the path we've been taking.
Yeah,
and then just head right on the first fork of the road.
That's gonna lead us to the same area.
It was literally one road path that went from all the way from that spot where we could see on the map to here.
Yeah, but I would have seen the tower if it was on the road. And it's not on the road.
We
must have walked past it.
We were busy avoiding combat.
Oh, there. It's not on the road.
Oh, so we were wanting to go to the tower first?
Yeah, well, we got to. We can't even see the map here.
Oh, hey.
Alright, so... Wow, that's way far off there. Holy smacks.
If you zoom in with the Sheikah slate, we can mark it as a waypoint.
Take a shortcut.
That is not a shortcut.
Come on. Turn. Need better steering radius.
Horses don't turn on a dime.
It should turn on something.
It was, though. You're treating it like it's a hover car.
Well, that can move any direction. Steers like a hover car in all the other games. Why would I assume it's going to be realistic in this one when Epona in Twilight Princess ran at max gallop and could make 90-degree, almost 360-degree turns on a dime?
Wow, that's broken.
The bird didn't even notice me. I'm running so fast. Like, render
distances. Oh, a big guy.
Oh, mama. Not up the mountain. Not up the mountain. We need to be going faster than that, because the big guy notices us. I don't want to fight the big guy. I don't even want to know how dangerous that thing is.
Yeah, since it seems like the how you level up in this game is the spirit orbs you get
right
from the shrines.
Killing things is pretty much harvesting items. Shit!
Well,
they're everywhere! Yeah, we're going to try and avoid it. We can outrun them anyway.
Go, go, go. Up the hill.
We're gonna have to kill him.
Oh, hey, a fox. Nope, you're good.
All right, or magnetism. That's great.
Oh, look at all these thorns.
Yeah. Can't pick them up, though.
I'm pretty sure they're going to hurt.
Ow. Yep.
Latino Tower. Well, Boomerang can't swipe them.
Do I have Boomerang left? I do. Ow. Alright, so there's a specific way they want you to climb this tower.
Yeah, we got this.
Alright.
We got stamina potions and stuff. If only you had that potion that made you climb faster. Oh wait, you do.
I do.
Is it the blue ones? Hasty, yep. Let's see how well it works, since we got like three of them.
Yeah. It is a little bit.
Yeah, it's a low level.
I think if I get hit while climbing, I'd fall to my death.
And for 5 minutes, too. That lasts quite a while.
Right. Oh boy, we're going to need a stamina. Oh, look at that. Too many hearts.
Are there any...
Too many hearts.
Oh, what's that bottom one?
It's full.
The very last one. Wow, that one's a lot.
Ugh, full everything.
I guess we'll use one of the ones from the first screen?
Yeah, maybe. Let's see what this did. That's five. This one over here only did four.
Yeah, but it heals
way
more
stamina.
I would say that.
Alright, well, we'll go climb a little more and probably eat that one.
Yeah. Wait until you're in the red. Okay. I like how you can just eat while climbing. Boom. I think this is the worst part of the climb, too.
Right. I agree.
I
don't actually have to climb back down.
I wonder if the, you're eating up more stamina because you're climbing faster.
That's an interesting question. Did the potion actually lower the stamina regeneration?
It seems like it's not going faster than it normally did when climbing.
Right, it seems to be.
So I think it is just you increase your climbing speed for the amount of stamina.
Which would logically make it go down more.
Yeah.
Because you're moving faster.
It's pretty awesome. Epona just like gallops sideways all the way up it.
like Epona slid down the hill. Epona just like climbs up it. I'm trying to say Epona's name as if Epona doesn't really have a gender. I don't really know what gender the horse is, and the game doesn't really tell you.
I would go with she. I would say Epona would be a she.
Epona was a she in Twilight Princess, but Epona was a solid brown horse in Twilight Princess.
Yeah.
This Epona is definitely not that Epona, by every means of the word. Because that Epona is probably, like, the best horse in this game.
It looks like you're going into a fish's mouth. It's like, oh, ah. And we made it.
All right.
Woo.
Download this into my iPad.
Get the iTower app. Shiga Tower activated. Cue cutscene. Hey, link between the past and pretty much every Zelda game ever was Railroad Central.
Those games were Railroad Central as well. Wind Waker, not so much.
The opponent's like, you okay, Kay?
Oh, well, you get down here.
Oh, hey, there's a blue vocabulary.
Ha!
Wow. Wait, can you whistle while gliding?
I'm definitely not going to try it this high up.
Oh, I was thinking you could glide further ahead and like whistle
and
the opponent would catch up.
Maybe.
So that way you could avoid that guy.
I'm gonna have to fight him anyway.
Alright, let's end this episode on a combat then.
Yeah, sounds good.
Oh, what?
Didn't take any damage.
I'm still surprised at the...
Alright, so...
Wait, switch out from the boomerang.
That guy?
Because yeah, you still got the boomerang going.
This boomerang's nice, but I feel as though I've been gypped by the damage that does. Let's test these guys out.
Yeah, I would say...
effective these
I would say the boomerang would be good when you're on horseback.
Right.
Because you could throw it while galloping away.
Oh, yeah. Let's get his attention the Link way.
Hit his head.
Hey.
Nice. Down my face.
Wow. Holy crap. He goes flying.
Oh,
bye. Yeah, he died. Holy crap.
Sweet. Wait, now you got a sword. Try chopping the thorns. Like, hold it. Hold the attack. Whoa.
Oh my god. They're indestructible.
Okay.
They're an immovable, indestructible object of indestructible.
They're evil Ganon thorn vines.
They're satanic vines of evil satanic power.
Can you use the sword while on your opponent?
Probably not. Because I need a hand to wield the...
Oh my god.
I can wield my... It's a pathetic attack.
But still, using a claymore and horseback?
Yeah, that's pretty impressive.
Just hit him on our way out. Just be like, screw you.
Yeah. Alright, let's try to ride past and attack him on the way out.
Yeah, we don't know what the big guy's capable of, and we might get a big club from him. Nope, normal club.
Oh my god. Whoa.
Oh, he's weaker than the blue guy.
Whoa. Nope, bad horsey.
Now that might work in your advantage.
Oh, God.
Now the Bokoblin can't get to you.
Well.
Yeah, see? They're
maybe,
like,
yeah.
They're probably going to get a bow to shoot you.
Yeah, probably.
Or
crap. I don't even need to go this way. This is south. I need to go north.
Yeah.
Actually.
Wait, get off Epona so Epona's out of combat.
Get over this way. I'm going to try and ride out. I'm going to try and get over this way.
Link with the claymore, that's pretty badass.
Whoa. Hopefully this connects over there somewhere.
I don't think that connects.
Because if not, I think my horse is dead.
I wonder if the horses
really
have health.
I don't think my horse can get down there.
Because, I mean, they haven't shown the horse's health bar at all.
Right. Nope. I don't think horsey's going to go that way. Horsey's not going that
way. Oh, well, the phone is smart enough... to not go that way, but when it comes to going down a hill.
Looks like I gotta go this way. Alright, enough of your sass. Come on. Yeah, come on. Let's go this way. We gotta move. Can't stand here. I don't wanna fall into the abyss. That is not on my list of things to do. It might be on yours, horse. Yeah, come on. You got it? Fine. Let's go down the mountain. This seems to be the direction you want to go.
So you can fight the really big guy with the really big stick.
No, come on. You're already going this way.
Here, just get off Epona. Pew.
Oh, my face!
Ow, my face!
Yeah, just get off your pony.
Oh, my face!
Oh, I'll see you later.
Oh, my face again! Alright, come on.
Okay, Epona does not like mountains.
Alright.
This is not Skyrim.
Okay. See you later, horse. I'll have to find another one. Bye-bye, Epona. You were nice. Oh, he throws rocks.
Try whistling.
Hang on. I gotta deal with this.
Oh, look at his tongue sticking out. His blue tongue. Oh, he's not that tough. That was only half a heart.
Alright. Come on. Oh, right. I forgot. Yep. Thanks. Appreciate it.
Heal. Oh, man.
This attack speed's killing me. It's almost broken,
just,
too.
Just let it break and then switch. But first, definitely heal. Since the roasted apples are already cooked and you can't add them as ingredients, might as well, or baked apple, might as well eat them all. Oh, holy crap. Rolling down the hill.
Will you stop winging around down the hill? Alright,
oh, so now it broke.
Alright, so the rusty claymore's not so amazing. Let's try this guy out.
Your one-handed weapon. Go.
Much faster attack speed.
Bang. All those wings. Moblin,
that's Moblin.
And a horn? Ooh, wait, is that something you can mine? Or bomb it?
Yeah, it's probably salt rock.
Here, try calling Epona. Seems Epona isn't able to come. Great, you got Epona stuck.
Stupid horse.
Yeah, how dare that horse have the rider make it go into a spot where it's stuck.
I did not make the horse go down the effing hill. The horse was like, hey, this looks like a good path. Let's just fucking run down the damn mountain. You're supposed to stay still. I'm gonna climb the hill so I can place the bomb on top of the thing I need to. Alright, let's do that.
I'm not sure that. Here, drop it.
Alright, good enough. Damn it. Oh, just enough. Flint and
luminous stone.
Pale blue glow in the dark, which believes sun to be souls of the dead. Apparently the stone can be used as a base to make some special clothing. Ooh.
Oh, wait, instead of placing the bomb, why don't you throw the bomb, and when it makes contact with the flint, or whatever that is, then detonate.
Alright, great.
Whoa, what's that?
That's more than glowstone, I think.
Yeah, because you shot it, and it started glowing.
That's cool.
Yeah.
More of that around here. Yeah.
Oh, hey.
Bomb arrow.
You sure you
have
wanna...
one? I have probably just one. Oh,
you
no,
have
I got two. Well, this glowy stone says we need it.
Well, hopefully you don't run into those rhino things that you need to feed bombs. That was your sword, sir.
Thanks.
I think someone needs to remember the controls.
I remember the controls perfectly fine. It's Link that doesn't remember the controls.
Sure.
I remember that there's a button that does things.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Horse is dead. Oh well.
That's a shame.
Yeah, it really kind of liked the horse, too.
Horse isn't dead, but... kind of...
Alright, great. Give me that.
Screwed it over by running into the mountain with it.
God bless it all. Come on.
Try throwing it like you did with the others. Ooh, two.
Oh, I got two. Nice. You need to make special clothes. Probably glow-in-the-dark clothes. Yeah, you know what? This looks like a good spot to stow.
Yeah, you got these.
It's like a good
spot
to bokoblin skeletons.
Come on. Come on, Skellies, get out of here. We're trying to end an episode. Oh, as long as one skull is left, the bodies animate.
Nice.
Alright, now we're ending it.
Don't want the arm. Alright. See you next time.